family's cottage in Muskoka for about 1 week. So nice to be able just to relax and get caffeinated, which we're going to talk about in 1 second. But before we do, I have a question for you. Is there a better non-caffeinated beverage than bubbly water? Not sponsored, by the way, but so good. Oh. Now, this video is sponsored by Standard Magazine. So let me tell you about today's sponsor before we get started and I show you everything in there. Because listen, I'm not a reader, okay? I don't like to read, but I am a visual learner. And for me, I love magazines. I used to grow up going to the magazine stand, trying to find car magazines or even like video game magazines, just things that would catch my attention as a kid. And I love Standard because it is a visual learning experience for me. If you use the link down in the description below, you can get shipping worldwide and support this channel. Now, if you love coffee, you want to learn more about specialty coffee, and you just want a beautiful magazine to do that, definitely check out Standard Magazine down in the description below or standardmagazine.com/Kyle, and you get shipping worldwide absolutely free. Thank you so much, Standard, for sponsoring this video. So here in Muskoka, Canada, there are no specialty coffee shops, not a single one. I think there's a cafe about an hour away from me, but it's just not feasible. So every year I've got to bring all my coffee stuff. Now you see, I thought this would be fun because I've been meaning to make an updated brew bar tour for a while anyways. It's the middle of 2021. So rather than wait for that, why not just show you my cottage brew bar tour? Let's check it out. Okay, come on in. Don't worry about the mess right now at the cottage. Now, this is normally where I have my brew bar set up. This is kind of where my family sets up all their coffee stuff. But I'm going to show you everything that I've been using here. Now, we're going to talk about a few things today. We're going to talk about, number one, what am I using to grind my coffee? Number two, we're going to talk about what I'm using to make espresso. I'm also going to talk about what I'm using to make filter coffee as number three. And then last but not least, I'm going to talk about how I'm getting consistent, good quality coffee, similar to what I would have at home. Because water here in Muskoka is pretty terrible quality. So I'm going to dive right into this and give you some of my favorite pieces of equipment to make coffee at the cottage. Now, a few things here. None of this is necessary. You don't need to spend a ton of money to be able to brew coffee on the go. If you want something cheap, something affordable, and something reliable and versatile, the AeroPress is your best friend, okay? I'm gonna leave some links down for everything I'm gonna show you today down in the description below, but the first one I'm gonna link is the AeroPress. And it's gotta be mentioned. Now, I didn't bring the AeroPress. I've actually lent it out to some friends, so I don't have an AeroPress with me today, but it's gotta be mentioned. The AeroPress is definitely one of the best travel coffee pieces of gear that you can get. Okay, so let's dive right into this. What am I using to brew and grind my coffee with, rather? What am I using to grind my coffee with at the cottage? Well, I've got a few different options. I've actually got way more than I need, but I'm testing a few pieces of these gear for future videos that I've been talking about already. Number one is, this is the Fellow Ode. Now, I've already talked about this in some other videos, which I will link above right here, but this is a great grinder for filter coffee. Now, I've got a few different grinders, and the reason why I brought the Fellow Ode is because we wanted to do big batch brews as a family. And so the Fellow Ode is really great for that. It has an 80 gram capacity in the hopper, but more importantly, it just grinds really fast. But this grinder is also meant just for filter coffee. I do really like the Ode for filter coffee, even without the new burr that's gonna be coming out later this year. All right, guys, so this is where things get a little ridiculous. I've got three hand grinders. I've got the Onesie Presso or Easy Presso JX. I've got the Commandante C40. And this, I think they call this chocolate fine line. And then the newest grinder that I have, this is the Timor Chestnut X. Now you might be wondering, Kyle, what in the name of grinders are you doing with three hand grinders? Definitely don't need all three of these. The reason why I brought three of these to the cottage is because I am working on a showdown of premium hand grinders, similar to the one that I did right up here. You can find of my budget hand grinders, and so many of you guys loved. I'm working on a premium version for all of you, and I really want to bring that out soon. So I wanted to test these while I'm on vacation. That's going to include these three. So stay tuned for that. Be sure to subscribe if you're not already so you don't miss that. And turn the notification bell on if you don't want to miss that when it becomes live. So my go-to has been the C40 for filter coffee here at the cottage. Anytime I really want to make a great cup of coffee, I'll use the C40. 40 for that. And I'm gonna describe why in a future video, but this is definitely a great grinder for filter, not so great for espresso. And that's where these two grinders come in real nicely. I'm using this JX right now for the Cafe Let robot, and I'm using the Time More Chestnut X for the X bar. And we're gonna talk about these guys soon because this one has a lot of adjustability. It's got a lot of micro adjustments. So they've each got their each niche, what they're good for. And it's been nice having three, but guys, one is plenty. Let's talk about espresso. Espresso brewing at the cottage, there's a few different options. I did just record the Pico Presso from Wakeco, and I did bring that as well for when we're camping or we're on the run, going up in some mountains, doing some hikes. You can find that video right here. But at the cottage, we have a little bit more time in the morning. We have a little bit more time to prep stuff. Again, this is a little excessive. Not everybody needs espresso at the cottage, but if you want it, if you want to be able to make good espresso on the go, one of my favorite manual espresso brewers is the Cafe Lat robot. Now, I'm working on a video right now to compare this to others like the Flair 58 and also this X bar right here. But if you haven't heard about the Cafe Lat robot, let me quickly tell you about it. This is a manual espresso brewer, and I think it's just charming. I mean, my wife Natasha, you like the looks of this machine. Yeah, it's pretty sick. It looks pretty cool. It looks retro. Real quickly, how it works is you take this little chamber out. This is kind of like the portafilter, if you will. This has got a 58 millimeter portafilter basket in here. And I've got some accessories on this Cafe Lat robot, like an upgraded tamper, which is a definite must for this guy. They call these the mittens on the hands. And what I don't have right now, what I'm not showing, is a rubber band that normally holds these guys up when it's not in use. Didn't bring that to the cottage, but normally I would have that as well. And it's pretty simple, just like you would with any other espresso brew. You'd fill its portafilter with espresso grounds, fill this with water, and then press. Now, what's really interesting about the robot is that this guy claims, get this, Paul Pratt, the owner of Cafe Lat, says that the robot does not need preheating. We're gonna dive into that in a future video. And then I'm also using this right here. This is the X Bar, and this is one of the newer espresso toys. So the people at X Bar did send me this to test out and review. And this again is another 58 millimeter portafilter brewer. Now, this wouldn't necessarily be classified as manual espresso. It would kind of be a hybrid between an espresso machine and a manual espresso brewer. This is why. It uses CO2 to brew espresso. You see, you put CO2 canisters in the side pocket right here to power this machine. It doesn't have a press. You can't manually use a lever system to brew espresso in here. You've got to set it up with either CO2 canisters, or you can actually hook up a pump, like a bike pump or an electric pump, to the back of this machine here to actually deliver power to it. So it's kind of unique. I don't know if I would consider this portable espresso. Now, what's really cool about the X Bar, come in here real quick, Natasha, is this right here is a flow profiler. Just like something like my Bianca or a Slayer, with the CO2, and you have to have the CO2 installed for this, you can flow profile the espresso on the X Bar. So kind of cool. Is this portable? I don't know. Would you consider this to be portable? Yeah, I don't know. I don't think this is necessarily a portable device. Now, I'm gonna be giving this away in a future video, in that video that I'm working on, so stay tuned for this. Let's talk about filter coffee. Nothing crazy here. I'm using 3 pour over drippers. I know, guys, this is so excessive and definitely not necessary, but this is me we're talking about. So what I brought was, first off, the Fellow X. This is one of my favorite flat bottom brewers for good reason. This one is great because it is portable and it's very durable. You know, this is stainless steel. I don't have to worry about this breaking, throwing this in the bag, throwing this in the backpack. It's not gonna break. It's not ceramic. It's not even plastic. This will last. And so I brought it for that reason, as well as the Kalita in the same boat. Again, stainless steel, it's durable, it's great. But the thing is, flat bottom brewers are both awesome. The Kalita 185 is great for bigger brews. The Stag X is great for smaller brews. But I love conical brewers. I love the V60. I love the clarity that it delivers. And I just couldn't pass up bringing it. And so I risked bringing my ceramic V60. But if you're watching this and you're interested in buying a V60, what I'm gonna link down below is the plastic version of this, because I don't think this model here is actually the best to travel with. I think the plastic version of the V60 is not only more durable for traveling with, it's cheaper and it's better for heat retention than the ceramic. You know, the ceramic, when I bought this has lasted me 4 or 5 years, but if I was to buy this over again, I'd probably just get the plastic one. So check that out. These are all great. Now you're probably wondering, what filters am I using for these? I'm using the proprietary ones from Fellow for the Stag X. I'm using Kalita's 185 filters for the Kalita. Now for the V60, I'm changing it up a little bit on this trip, and I decided not to bring any Hario V60 filters. I normally use the ones with the little tab. These are the filters that I'm using, and I might pronounce this wrong, but these are the Kafek Osmetic Flow Light Roasted Coffee Paper Filters. And these are the 2-4 cup filters. And these are interesting. They're a little thicker than the Hario ones. And I've had to change my recipes and grind a little coarser to compensate for that. Also, I'm brewing all of these on the Stag X. And we brought our own kettle. This is a great gooseneck kettle if you want good pour overs. You want good control on the water flow. Again, I'll link this down below, but the Stag is a wonderful option. If you want to get this a little cheaper, I do have a discount code for any Fellow gear, including the Fellow Stag X, wherever I put that right here. And it's 10% off if you use Kyle10 code at fellow.com. Let's talk about how I'm keeping my coffee tasting well, even here at the cottage. So here at the cottage, we have terrible water. The water quality is bad. I wouldn't drink it. We actually have to use spring water bottles just to brush our teeth. Like, it's that kind of water. So what we use here instead is a 4-liter bottle here in Canada, but a gallon in the States. And I use a packet of the Third Wave Water mineral supplements. It's a little packet like this, but it also comes in, like I said, Perfect Coffee Water or Aqua Code, which is a liquid version. And I add one of these to a bottle of distilled water. It's gotta be distilled, and you're basically adding all the minerals you would normally have in water, but at the perfect concentration for what coffee need. And that's why things like this really matter. So if you have never tried Third Wave Water, I will link this down below. Huge supporter. I love their products. I love the people behind this brand, as well as Perfect Coffee Water and Aqua Code. I'll link all these down below. Two other things I quickly forgot to mention. I'm using the Kinto server, and my scale of choice for this week is a little overboard, but it's kind of the theme of this video. That is the Akaya Lunar. This is an espresso scale. There's a couple reasons why I did bring it. First off, the Cafe Lat robot is kind of awkward to put a scale in. And without something small as the Lunar, or honestly, you probably need the smaller version of the Prixie, it just doesn't fit. And so if you were to use like a Hario scale or anything bigger, it's really hard to measure your espresso on that. But this thing will last. Like, this is a really durable scale. It's also like $300. So, definitely way overboard, definitely not something you need, but this is made for a cafe setting. Now, before you go, you may notice on the channel, you're gonna be starting to see some YouTube shorts. Actually, how cute is he? Stick with me on the YouTube shorts. I just wanna test it out. The platform seems to really favor creators who are doing this, and I just wanna be able to be as creative as I can. And so if YouTube's really pushing creators to do this, I'd be dumb not to take advantage of that and make some videos on that. So I might recycle some of my TikToks and some of my Instagram reels and post them there. So don't worry, that's not gonna affect these videos. And if you like, go over, watch them, hit a like, it would really help out this channel. Speaking of which, if you're not yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button down below for more videos like this and more of those reviews like I talked about. Hit this like button if you enjoyed this, if it was at all entertaining. It really helps with the YouTube algorithm. It's just crazy. I hate even having to ask these things, but statistically, even asking it just will help you hit that like button. And like I said earlier, if any of the products interest you, they're all linked down in the description below. Thank you, Standard Magazine, for sponsoring this video. We'll see you guys all next time. Bye.